Hello, it's Jake, and you've seen me rank Quedeca's discography. Hell, you might have even seen me rank Charlie XCX and Paramore's discography. But today, we're gonna be ranking the Frank Ocean discography. This was requested by Daniel McGrath, and this video is going to follow a very similar format, ranking Frank Ocean's discography from worst to best. Keep in mind, these are all just my opinions, and ultimately at the end of the day, I don't see Frank Ocean really having a bad song at all in his catalog, so even the song that is at the very bottom of this list is still a very good song. Before we get too deep into the video, I did cut out some of the interludes or just shorter sections on some of these albums, especially Endless. And in general, when it came to ranking some of the tracks on Endless, it was kind of a hard task to accomplish. But I feel pretty good with my placements here, and at the end of the day, it's just my opinion, man. You might have a different ranking, so if yours is different, please leave your top 5, 10, 20 Frank Ocean songs in the comments below. Without further ado, let's get this thing started. Starting off the list at number 62, we have the track Mine. Yeah, I don't feel like there's a lot to really say about this song here. It kinda sounds like a brain being rebooted, and I feel like that's a good enough reason to put it at the lowest spot on this list. Number 61, Impietus. I will say I do like the cool little clinks, clanks, and scratches on this song. Number 60, DHL.
Ladies and gentlemen, anybody want to tell me just what in the Mr. Shish Kebab Shannon is going on here?
Okay, list is over. Pack it up. We're out of here. I know I'm already canceled. I certainly like the first half of this song, but when the second half comes in, I do feel that it drags on for a little bit more than it's welcome. At number 59, I have the song Nature Feels. Don't get me wrong, I think this is a damn good cover, but I still prefer the original song to this version. Number 58, Pilot Jones. I see a lot of hatred for the song Monks being spewed on the internet, and I am certainly not having it. This is my least favorite song off Channel Orange, and y'all are gonna have to explain to me the Monk slander later. Number 57, Xenons. In general, I just like the spacey vibe that this short track is able to paint. Number 56, Sierra Leone. I like the way that Frank sings teenagers on this song. Also, I don't live in Denver. Number 55, We All Try. I think my favorite aspect about this song has to be the almost spoken word-like delivery Frank uses on the chorus of the song. At number 54 to number 51, I have four of the transitional tracks from Endless. At the end of the day, the placement of these four songs could ultimately be interchanged any sort of way, and it really wouldn't be that different to me. Consider these some of the better connecting segments on Endless, but there are still a handful that are a step better. At number 50, I put the song Super Rich Kids.
Hey, bro, come on now, dawg.
Is this slander? I don't know. Maybe. I don't really care. At the end of the day, this song just never quite got me going like the other songs off of Channel Orange. At number 49, I put the song Sweet Life. And this song just barely edges out Super Rich Kids for having the line, "The best song wasn't the single." Number 48, Provider. This track is another one of my least favorite of the Frank Ocean mystery bag of singles, but at least there's like four different versions of this song, so I'm sure I'll like one of them much more. Number 47, Mitsubishi Story. This song is a bit of a weird one, having a very bouncy first half and being a little spacey in the midsection before completely falling apart by the back end of the song and ending out the album Endless. Number 46, Alabama. I like the very sparse nature of this track and the way that Frank's vocals bounce from ear to ear throughout the song. Number 45, Moon River. I like this song, but it's always gonna forever be White Ferrari Jr. for me. Number 44, In My Room. I originally had this song at 41, but I had to bump it down to 44 because honestly, it's not better than and it's not better than or either. Number 43, Lens. On release of this track, I really wasn't rocking with it that much, but it certainly has warmed up on me over time. The first minute of the track can be a little bit to get through, but once you get past that first minute, this whole experience turns into a very, very heartwarming listen. Number 42, I put Wither. Wither is kind of like Alabama, it's just a bit more longer and a bit more fleshed out overall as an experience. Number 41, Biking Solo. Let's be honest, biking is always going to be more fun with the boys. Number 40, who blows? It's really hard to understate how much Jasmine Sullivan carries this track. Number 39, Dear April. Some of my favorite elements in this song would have to probably be the chiptune vocals or just that consistent scraping along the guitar you hear throughout the track. Number 38, Dust. Somebody I know is probably not going to be very happy with my placement of Dust on this list, but that's okay. I really love Dust, and once it gets moving, I'm fully behind it, but this song just doesn't have the immediate grab that some of the other songs higher on this list have for me. Number 37, Strawberry Swing. I'm not even gonna lie, I like this version significantly more than the Coldplay version of this song. I think that the Coldplay version subdues the vocals, whereas Frank's version puts them on center stage where they're supposed to be. Number 36, I put Cayendo. Cayendo's a fun one because if you go out of your way to actually look up the translations of these lyrics, the song probably won't make any more sense to you. So yeah, the song's a little bit broken, but it's still a vibe. Number 35, Rushes. I think going forward at this point, it's become pretty clear that any long-form acoustic song from Frank is going to hit my soft spot. Number 34, Monks. I fucking told you I wasn't gonna stand for this Monk slander. Okay, maybe I'm gonna stand for a little bit of this Monk slander. It's not my favorite song, but if you could, please explain to me below, why do people hate this song so much? Number 33, Unity. Man, never trust a pre-roll. Number 32, Bad Religion. I think that this song pulls off a nice little bit of a dual meaning in its song lyrics. On one hand, being about a one-sided relationship, but on the other, exploring some of the treatment of gay and bisexual individuals by various religious groups. If this is a topic that makes you uncomfortable or you don't like seeing discussed in music, grow up, I don't care, move on. Number 31, At Your Best. This track is really weird, having a very grand nature to it, but yet remaining so simple. I would love to see this song be the intro or closer to a movie soundtrack. Number 30, American Wedding. Yeah, this song just takes a very spot-on-the-nose jab at the traditional American wedding, and I'm all here for it. Don't Google 50% of marriages. Number 29, I put Higgs. And Higgs might just have my favorite vocal performance on the entirety of Endless. Number 28, Love Crimes. I swear that chorus is more infectious than COVID-19 itself. And the way Frank Ocean slows down the vocals at the end of the song is super dope. Number 27, Biking with the Homies. The memories that I have with this song in particular are honestly countless. And all I want to urge you to do is, if you have friends and you got a couple bikes and you got some free time, go out and go ride around for a little bit, because you won't be able to get those memories forever. Oh, there's Blonde. So yeah, at number 26, I have the song Close to You. Gun to my head, if you made me pick a least favorite song off of Blonde, this would probably have to be my choice, but that is really a tough choice to be making at the end of the day. If Close to You at number 26 isn't evident of what's going to be taking a majority of the top of this list, strap in, because there's a lot more Blonde to go. Number 25, Solo Reprise. You know, getting an Andre 3000 verse on your album is a bit like getting a legendary Pokemon. Most people only get one chance at it, and if you fuck it up, you're not gonna get another one. Number 24, Skyline 2. This song is a bit similar to Lens in that the first minute is a little bit to get through, but once you get past that, everything is a very sweet and just great experience. I also like the ad-libs on this song of Smoke, Blur, and Haze. Number 23, There Will Be Tears. It was either this song or another one coming up a little bit on the list that was my first introduction to Frank, and I think because of that, this song is gonna have a certain bit of sentimental value to me pretty much forever. Number 22, Nikes. So I'm pretty aware to the fact that the auto-tune on the vocals isn't for everybody here, but it certainly works for me. Number 21, Thinking About You. Thinking About You is a song that I think is safe to say is undeniably a good song, but I don't find myself going out of the way to listen to this song nearly as much as I thought I would. Number 20, Swim Good. It may be a bit cheesy of a song, but I think sticking to the themes and the really good storytelling throughout the song is what sells this song for me. Number 19, Lost. You know, this song has 1 billion streams on Spotify, and I can only think of one reason of how it got that high. Number 18, Pink and White. Let the lyrics on this song serve as a disclaimer for you going forward. It's all downhill from here. Number 17, Novocaine. So as I said before, this or the other song mentioned previously might have been my first introduction to Frank Ocean. And I'm pretty sure it was this one because I have more memories associated to this one. And sticking true to the name, this song feels like audible Novocaine. I still get chills down my spine every time I hear this song. Number 16, Godspeed. The passion and soul in these vocals is so warm and smothering, almost like taking a nap with a really warm blanket. Number 15, Crack Rock. There is a lot of different territory I could go into when discussing this song, but I'm gonna keep it simple and say that I think the themes in this song are communicated and executed well. Number 14, Solo. Somehow over a bare instrumental with only an organ and a whistle, Frank somehow manages to keep my attention for the whole 4 minutes of runtime of this song. Number 13, Ivy. I swear each year that goes by, this song feels like a knife in the gut that just twists a little bit more each time you listen. Number 12, Pretty Sweet. I just like the chaos. I even like the airy, open nature of this song, and the creepy kids singing on the back end are surprisingly a nice touch as well. Number 11, Pink Matter. I hope we can all agree that this is a much more fairer treatment of this song. I have seen many people slap this thing down in their 50s or their 40s, and that is just downright slanderous. And not only does Frank Ocean get one Andre 3K feature, this guy somehow manages to get two of them. Dude's cheating. At number 10, I have the closer of Blonde, Futura Free. I feel like a lot of people disregard this song when it comes to the length. And sure, I don't go out of my way to play this song. But when I do listen to Blonde, I never cut this song short. Number 9, Forrest Gump. You know, I asked my friends who dislikes this song, and the answer they gave me was homophobes. Do with that as you will. Number 8, Nights. Nope, that's it. This is as far as this train will go. Nights will go no further. Nights would certainly be a very safe pick to put at number 1. But when it comes to Blonde as an entirety and as an experience, when I finish the album, I don't find myself looking back to the moments on Nights being the things that I remember the most from that experience. Number 7, Self-Control. What was that one thing that I said earlier? I think going forward at this point, it's become pretty clear that any long-form acoustic song from Frank is going to hit my soft spot. Yeah, that statement still stands. This song is adorable. Number 6, Chanel. First of all, Frank is absolutely flowing on this track. And second of all, Frank has been able to get a whole world of straight guys to sing the lyrics, "My guy pretty like a girl." Number 5, Songs for Women. I think if anything, this might be my wildest take on here. But I absolutely love the cheesy storytelling on this song, and I find it hilarious that there are guys out there that would get mad at Frank for having songs that would help him pull women. And lastly, that line about Frank having his girl battle rap him is downright hilarious as well. Number 4, Slide on Me. If I was including the Blonded Radio and various other release songs by Frank, the Young Thug version of the song would be even higher than this spot on the list. But even without Young Thug's placement on the track, I think Frank flows along this song effortlessly, and the sub on this track is absolutely insane. Number 3, White Ferrari. I'm not gonna lie, I'm really unsure if this is my number 1, 2, or 3 along with the other two songs above it. This song is absolutely stunning and beautiful from start to finish, and nearly every time I play it, it's able to get me right on the verge of tears. And hell, this song even transitions into another song that I like a lot as well. And just for a little extra tidbit of information, this is apparently Lil Yachty's favorite song of all time. Number 2, Pyramids. This song is 8 minutes, and it uses all 8 of those minutes to its advantage. This song is honestly such an expansive journey with some of the highs and the funky nature of the song Lost, but also providing some of that grimy and dark nighttime aesthetic in the middle of the track as well. All before transitioning into this very cinematic outro with a nice electric guitar and these vocals that sound like they're coming straight out of a voice box. Again, like the track before this one, at a certain point in my life, this was probably my number one Frank Ocean song, and I could see it going back up there sometime in the future as well. Okay, coming in at number one, my favorite Frank Ocean song is Siegfried. It's Siegfried. If White Ferrari is able to get me on the verge of tears with every listen, this song calls the full-on waterworks into effect. Whether it's the beginning section with the repetition of the line, "I'm not brave," or if I somehow manage to save the waterworks for the end, Frank will get me with the line, "I'll do anything for you." At the end of the day, this song is a gut punch and heartbreaking in the best way possible, and I could not see Blonde being the same experience it is without this song being on the album. And for that very reason, that is why Siegfried is my number one pick. But what was your number one pick? I'm pretty sure it was different from mine. I really do want to hear from you guys, so if you enjoyed the video, please leave a comment down below. And if your top 10, top 20, top 30 is different, please let me know what your favorite songs are down below as well. It would certainly mean a lot if you want to see more content from me in the future if you took the time to like and subscribe to the channel. But with all this out of the way, that's been Frank Ocean. Is there another artist you'd like me to do a similar video on, ranking from worst to best, or do you just want me to cover a certain album or something like that? Let me know down below and I'll try to get to it when I can. But it's been Jake, take care, have a good night, love.